replace the stock shifter with a Barton Industries shifter. Notice I got a little bit of play here. I had a lot of issues shifting from third to fourth very smoothly. That's not all the time. It's just usually when I'm trying to push it to the limit and trying to hit fourth gear and it just gets stuck or misses the gate. So they say the Barton Industries shifter is self-centering and all this other great stuff that's going to fix all these issues that I'm having with the stock shifter. So I'm going to go through disassembly. The hardest part about doing this is getting over your fear of ripping out the center console, in my opinion. You know, it's one of those things where I'm like, oh, maybe I can do all the work through this little hole, but you can't. I've taken out the center console a few times and it is a piece of cake. The hardest part about taking the console is removing all your crap from the center console here. So we're going to go through step by step of removing the console, disassembly, reassembly, and hopefully a little quick test drive. I've driven the Barton, I've driven a Hellcat with the Barton shifter, and I got to say it is a night and day difference. It's not just people posting crap online going, oh my god, I spent $500 on a Barton shifter and it's a night and day difference, trying to prove to themselves that they didn't waste their money.
This is about a good spot right here. Everything looks good.
It's a fun spot right here, right?
Yeah.
You can kind of do a little...
There is actually a night and day difference between this stock shifter and the, you know, driving with the Barton. It's literally like you're just going up and down and the shifter knows where to go. So... hopefully I get the same effect when I get it into my car. And as you can see here, my stock shifter is wearing out. My hands are generally pretty dry. They're not sweaty or clammy all the time. So I don't know why this wore off. But, you know, I've only got 15,000 miles on here. And, you know, I'm already showing the copper here. So we're going to get started. And we're going to start by ripping this out. And we'll go from there.
All right. So here's what you're going to need for the install. This is just in case, and you need a large screwdriver for leverage to get the pins in. You'll see that come into play later on. You're going to need a 13 millimeter and a 10 millimeter half inch drive socket with an extension. You're going to need a quarter inch drive. You're going to need a 7 millimeter and a 10 millimeter and an extension. You're going to need a 5/8 open end and a adjustable just to get the shift ball off. Screwdriver just for prying, just in case, some kind of metal spudger or tweaker screwdriver for popping off some pieces there. You're going to need a hook to help with those clips, and I'm using a 19 millimeter open end for the shift ball and an interior pry tool just in case. Also a rag if you want to do some interior cleaning while you got everything ripped apart. And that's all I use for this install.
You can use interior pry tools along this edge, but I found I don't like to use pry tools along the leather. Actually, the first thing we need to do is remove the pro clip. And take that out of there. Get my phone off of there. All right, so for this part, this cup holder in here is a little movable. So what I do is I hook my fingers underneath the cup holder and I pull upwards. And you can snap all these out without using interior tools, which is pretty cool. All right, once you get this hinged, this pulls forward. But before you do that, you're going to want to pull this out. Now, again, you could stick interior tools in here, but there's no more need to because all you got to do is reach underneath and find the clips and pop them upwards. So now, again, no need for interior tools or the ability to accidentally do a little damage to your interior there. So pop all this up. It's a little more awkward, of course, but, you know, as you can see from my previous videos, I'm a big fan of not using tools on trim pieces unless you really need to. And that last one is a pain in the butt, so there's two in this corner here. There we go. All right, so now you got the shifter boot up. What I like to do is turn it sideways, and now you can pull this right out. All right. And push it down. Okay, now behind here there's one plug, and it's a just got to find the thumb clip. So you got the plug right here, just squeeze it, pull it out, and now this whole piece of trim has been removed. All right, And now we're going to switch the view so you guys can see what I'm working on. There's two screws right here and here, and there's two all the way back there that you're gonna have to pull out. So
to give you an idea where we are, here's the center console. We're going down inside. And what we've got is two 7mm screws. You can also use a Phillips head. And if you're like me, don't put those in the cup holder, because dropping them in the cup holder is going to be a pain, because you know you're going to be taking out the center console and obviously spilling them. So I'm going to drop them on the passenger floor for now. It's a good storage spot. And that's it. These two screws are the only thing that hold this panel in the front. Okay, so we've got two connectors here. We've got the USB. We squeeze the connector and pull it down, and we've got this guy. So let's start with this one because it's the biggest one.
Then you can get some good leverage to unplug it. You just squeeze this little thumb tab right there, and then you just pop this all back together again if you want. All right, now also this one here, same thing, is a little tab on the bottom. You want to pull it and separate it, and now you are done with this. Yep, everything else is inside. So we've got the connector for the control panel here. We've got the connector that connects the entire thing to the car, and then we've got the USB for all the stuff inside the center console. All right, now we're gonna take this to the back seat, and we're going to pop the two bolts that hold the center console in place, and then pretty much just lift it right out. Coming into the passenger side, right down there, pop this on there. We're gonna take this trap door out. My recommendation is to use either a small tweaker screwdriver or a metal spudger. It has to be real thin, but really strong. There's a little dot right down here. Let's see if I can move my thumb. A little dot right down there that you can get into. Wiggle it in, get behind it, and pry it out. There we go. All right, and inside here is a 10mm bolt. And again, placing these two parts on the front seat floorboard. Clean up and pry this out. I'm also using a quarter inch drive, which is kind of stupid. And I'm gonna set these parts again on the front seat and the floor.
Right, at this point, it's very important to have all the seats back as far as they're gonna go. Now, I want you to understand too, is when you remove the plugs here, your keyless entry system is gonna have a few issues. It's not gonna sense the keys in the car, so if you open and close the trunk, it's going to give you an alert and pop the trunk back open again. So just keep things in mind. Nothing's broken, but you're definitely going to need to, just be aware of that. Now, everything is loose. You're going to want to unplug anything you have plugged into your power ports. Just make sure everything in your console, nothing's going to fall out. And push the shifter boot down so you're below the white area here. And lift and slide back. You want to be careful not to scratch your dash. You want to be careful not to rip your shifter boot. You know, it's going to be a little bit of fumbling around here. Most likely I should have taken the shifter boot off first, but hey, we're already committed. So we're just going to have to work around it. Let's see, there's some wires there getting stuck on the shifter boot. There we go. Make sure nothing else is connected. And carefully, without scratching your steering wheel, for your seats, get this out of the car. Is there a clip back there? Hey, there's that clip I lost back in when I installed the AV kit. Now I can put my dashboard back together up top later. So this is the end of the vent. There's a clip right here keeping it in place. There we go. That was really easy. I didn't even need the interior tool. Get this piece out of the way. All right, for this one, we're coming down by the shifter. All right, so you got right here, you've got two notches, and this is on the original it's on the original shifter column right there. All right, so you've got two notches. You want to pull this all the way up, and then you want to slide a 5/8 around those two notches and get yourself maybe an adjustable wrench. All right, once you break that nut, you can remove this and
unscrew the stock shifter ball and shaft. So this here has an elastic connection on it, so you could basically just pull it around and release it. So just pull it off just like that.
All right.
So we've got the boot to remove. Undo one, two, three, four, five, six bolts. Get those out. All right. I keep going to lean on the center console and it's not there. You're gonna get some good video of me falling into the car in a minute. Get a little more manly ratchet here. Got all this done, get this out of the way, and this guy is a 13 millimeter. All right, now how do we get the metal plate off? Am I looking for the pry tool here? Yep. Okay, you want to jam a pry tool in there because it looks like there's a seal or a gasket around there. There we go. Ooh. Shifter's going to drop in. Going to take this, put it off to the side. Not knowing what the heck is going on. All right, so we get down into here. Now take a look at how loose this is. You're talking about right here and here. I mean, this whole thing is just a big wobble stick. So, let's see if the Barton improves upon that. All right, this 10 millimeter is a pain in the butt. You don't want to break it free with something. And then, it's got some Loctite in it, so it's pretty hardcore to get out. Not a lot of room to work. That's really going to come into play when I got to pull those clips off, which I'll show you in a sec. All right, so this guy is out. It's pain because of all the Loctite that was on there. Drop that, set it aside. That was at the end of a 10 millimeter bolt. Now the last thing is these two pins right here. Here and here, there's clips that have to be pulled off. And then they get pried out. Okay, so you gotta get your hook up behind. You'll notice this piece goes up over the ledge. You get your hook up behind inside there and pull it all the way back, and now this pin slides out. And I'm going to be careful because I don't want to drop this into the car, but you see that pin just slides right out, and we're all going to have a laugh if I drop this under the car. There we go. So we're going to make that, I'm going to make note of that and put that off to the right. Now I'm guessing there's the exact same thing on this side. Yeah, so the hook is in the back, so you got to get up underneath it and push down on this side to unhook it. And that is not easy. Oh, so there's a ledge over here you can push on. Yep, there you go. And you'll see you could spin that. So this one here, you're going to spin it from the back down and forward to bring it around. All right, and then you're gonna slide this thing out. Same thing. Oh, and there's no room. There we go. All right, so that one comes out down and forward. So basically this one is locked into this position here, and I'll show you this here. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna come around and push down from the top to unlatch this, swing it down and forward, and then slide it out and lift it right out. A lot of jiggle and play, a lot of rust in this bad boy too. But yeah, everything feels loose. You can't get a good idea of it, but this is kind of, you can actually feel it hitting metal to metal as I wiggle it back and forth. I mean, you know, overall, this is a crappy shifter. Ow, that really hurt. But let's see what the Barton has. By the way, give you a midpoint review. To be honest with you, this is not a hard job. If you have basic tool skills, I mean, all I've used is a hook, a couple of ratchets, open-end wrenches. You know, this really isn't something, you know, you should be afraid to install. So let's go and finish this job up. Oh, the wife's calling. Gotta go.
All right, so here's your comparison. This guy skipped leg day at the gym. This guy didn't. A shift ball. And I've got it accented in orange. You know, I liked it, but I've always had my heart set on the Speed Dawg Rally series. So I contacted them a while back, but they didn't make them for the stock shifter handle. And I mean, there's a way to pull this out and tap it and all that other stuff. But now that I finally got my Barton, I have my beautiful Speed Dawg Rally series shift knob. The cool part about this is the orange inlay actually goes all the way through. I'm not sure if you can see inside there, but the inlay is all the way through. So this is not going to wear off or rub off after time. Or at least I hope it's not, but we'll see. But I always kind of love this shift knob, and for over a year I've been staring at it. And now that I finally have a Barton, I can drop this bad boy on. So, all right, let's get to installing. All right, so continuing the theme of the 10 millimeter, we're gonna break this one free. Oops. Or we're gonna try to break that one free. I'm gonna take the shift ball off. I don't wanna do any damage to that. I was gonna try and do this one without getting cut, but that never happens. Okay, so put that back. Okay, so we're gonna line this up so I make it real easy to swap. Pull this pin out, bring it over, slide it on here. There we go. Nice, get it centered. Try not to scratch up the Barton. Okay. Now just be careful, this piece, you'll notice here, it is completely surrounded in rubber. So hopefully this is gonna dampen a lot of the vibration from the transmission. So your whole thing is completely shrouded in rubber. Only rubber comes into contact with the forks here. So I can't wait to see how that feels. We got rubber here, lots of rubber all around here. This thing's pretty legit. All right, so here's our comparison. Let's go see what she does. All right, we're back in the car with the Barton. We're gonna slide off this rear piece for now, set it aside. All right. Nice rubber to rubber. Get that in there, let that drop down. All right, so we're going back to the original clips. So you're gonna want to, you got this clip here, you've got the little tab right down there, you're gonna want to turn that down towards the ground. You know, I found holding it like this works best. Come up and around. Now if you drop it, it goes under the car, so that could be a pain. Once you get it started, you're gonna have to wiggle the Barton into place so you can actually get that clip in there, or get that piece in there. Once you get the nose in, there we go. You're gonna push that forward and it locks in right over the top in this groove right here. All right, so you just roll it up, okay, and then it clicks into place. Now this one on this side, there's not a lot of room in here, there's barely enough room to get the pin out, so this one I'm going to struggle with for a bit, and
probably gonna fast forward through a lot of it. So nice dirty GoPro there. All right, now you're gonna wanna start, you see this, it will orient the clip here. You wanna start, this locks around this way. So lock position is with the part on the bottom here. So you're gonna rotate it this way and slide it in. I notice with the Barton, there's not a lot of room to play in here because it's so much freaking bigger. And I got these big fat sausage hands, so this is gonna be a fun one. All right, so I got it in. I just need to, there is no leverage to push on this thing. Go right in there. Can you see that? So the clip is not in yet. I'm gonna push it all the way in. Grab it with my finger. All right. And then I'm gonna rotate this downward, which hurts like hell. Being on this side is just so much harder. I'm gonna try using my hook. See if that helps get a little more leverage. I guess I won't be using my hook then. So here's the problem. It didn't go in all the way. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the leverage from a screwdriver on the back of the pin. And I'm going to use that leverage to push the pin in while I wiggle the Barton shifter up and down a little bit. There we go, piece of cake. Went all the way in. Now I'm gonna use a smaller screwdriver. Now the leverage wasn't needed on this side because you have a lot of room to put your hand. Over on this side, there's nothing. Like you can barely even get the pin in on that side. So now we're gonna use the screwdriver, the edge of the screwdriver. Screwdriver cam. Use the edge of the screwdriver to roll that into place. Now, make sure that's clipped over the edge there. And you're good. All right, so that part's done. I'm gonna bring this up now. You wanna install this piece here. All right. Slide that in with the bolts out. Bring it down. Now you wanna install the linkage here. And that one has the bolt that we took off right here. Again, with the Loctite on it. And again, we got that 10 millimeter theme going. So we can give it a good little final pull. And then not be able to get this off. There we go. All right. So at this point, we have reconnected all the pieces. All right. We've got the clips, one, two here. We've got this guy here. All taken care of. Last piece left is to start reassembling. Now you'll see I got a little dirt and dust and grit here. Obviously while you're driving around, this is going to be rubbing up against that metal plate. So my recommendation would be to give it a good cleaning real quick. Using some Windex here just to wipe around this. I don't want to use spray wax or anything because there is a sticky coating on the surface there. So just get all the debris off of here. So we have a nice, and don't forget too, to go out around the screw holes, or the screw posts or the bolt posts, because that thing expands all the way over. Okay, now that we're nice and clean, everything looks good. We've got all the necessary parts in for now. With the top of the shifter, we'll worry about once we reassemble everything. All right, let's go get that plate. All right, you'll notice the rubber gasket here. I was wrong, it's not sticky. It's actually just, just the regular gasket material. I wiped it off outside the car. So now when we install it, there's no debris on that either. So Barton was nice enough to label this for us. We got the front, we've got the up, and we're gonna slide this thing in around. Actually, it's easier to come up from the bottom because the top is more pliable. So we're gonna pull in from the bottom and start working this around. Look at that, nice. Now we're ready to go. All right, now we're ready to go and slide this back in place. Again, I gotta pull this out. Slide that down. Lift up the shifter to get it in there. Man, you don't want to cooperate. You're so big. There we go. All right. Get the carpet out of the way. Make sure you got a nice firm seat. Get this guy back up there. This is a little bit of work here. I'm gonna get a bite on that. There we go. Now we can stop messing with it. All right, so you're gonna have to work this in and then keep pushing down the... My GoPro battery is getting low. I'm gonna go and tighten that up. There we go. Holy cow. You can barely feel how far these shifts go. I can't wait to see what this is like. Dude, this feels so much more solid. Holy crap. And you guys really don't need to see me putting these 6 bolts back on. All right, we got a little bit of GoPro battery back, and I'm gonna start putting all this back together again. One of the things I should have done, instead of fighting with this rubber shroud, is put it back down again so I can get at all the bolts. Let me bring you in for a close-up on that. See this piece right here? Here's a little rubber nub. Slide it on. Clamp it in place. All right, we got all the necessary pieces back in. Carpet up and over the top. Get the carpet out. So you don't have to peel the carpet back around and put, the rubber goes under the carpet. Let's put the plates on. So you have 4 bolts that'll hold this in place. Okay. So you're gonna use a lock washer and a bolt for each of these. So basically behind this is these sandwich on here. You slide this guy down, and now you have the ability to set your angle, which, man, that's gonna be annoying because I kind of like the stock angle and I didn't take measurement of what the stock angle was. So, yeah, we'll deal with that later. So we're gonna apply these loosely. As you can see, this thing is pretty beefy compared to... Now let's bring you guys down. All right. So now we're at the point where we have another lock washer and another regular washer on this bolt here. And these we're going to tighten down all the way. These are the bolts that hold the shift handle into the plate. And these could be secured tightly. And this will allow us to still adjust the shifter right and left until we get the perfect angle. Again, these we do all the way because these do not affect the ability to adjust. Same thing on the opposite side. There we go. We still have the ability to adjust this. I'll figure out where I want my ball in a bit. Just a little note, with the center console removed, your car is not going to work. You're going to get key fob not detected error. Yeah, service. Another mesh is about servicing the keyless system. And when you go to close your trunk, it's not going to close. So just a couple things to keep in mind while you are working on this with the center console out.
There's no major problem. Everything will, well, I should say, I hope everything will start working again once I plug everything back together. All right, so we're at the point here where we have this loose so we can adjust the tilt of the shifter. I want to get the whole center console put back in so I can get a feel for where everything is. So we're going to start putting that back together right now.
All right, so we're at the part where we're ready to put everything back together again. So the first thing you want to do is get all your tools out of the way. You want to make sure all of your bolts are tightened down correctly. Shifter feels so much better already. This is crazy. I can't wait to take this for a drive. It feels more solid. I don't even have the ball on top yet. All right, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bolts back in. We've got the rubber catch here holding this in place. These are my auxiliary wires for the taser. We're gonna push those out of the way past the air duct. Okay, so the first thing to go back in is gonna be the air duct. Okay, so remember the air duct has this little pin here and that connects back here to this little hole. Okay, so remember you wanna make sure you're not pinching any wires when you slide the air duct back in. I have my taser wiring in the way, so I'm gonna pull that up and over out of the way. Slide that back in. Find my slot. And push that Christmas tree pin right back in place. All right. Get my taser wiring over here so I can access it from back there if I need to. Okay, so this is in place. No bolts, no screws here, just one push pin in the back. Let's go on to the next step. Make sure all your seats are to the furthest back position. Up over your steering wheel. Make sure you don't scratch the leather on your steering wheel. And bring it back down into place. You want to move it all the way to the back seat. So then you can come down in here. Now you want to make sure your wiring harnesses are available. So you want to bring them forward. There's the two wiring harnesses. Okay, just get them past it. And then you want to tilt the back end up, slide it up and underneath your dash. So you got the two screw holes here. You want to line those up and drop this down. I have an interior tool in the way. There we go. Drop that right back down. Push it forward. And again, now you have the, make sure you have this available. This here is the control panel for here. We'll push that out of the way for a second. We're going to want to reconnect this big cable or big harness here. Make sure that snaps into place. And it has a clip here. You want to just pop that clip right back in. There we go. Okay, and then we have the gray harness or the gray USB plug here. You want to slide that back in place. I'm gonna bring you down inside for a second. So you wanna make sure this harness is reconnected and this clip goes back on. I think I broke the clip, so oops. Okay, and then you have the USB harness here that you snap back into place. This one right here, I'm wiggling it too fast for you. That one right there is gonna go into the back of your control panel here. And all right, let's get these two screws. We got one there. Give you a nice close up there. And one there. Those are 7mm. Phillips heads. So you can either use a 7mm or a Phillips head. I'll leave that up to you. You also want to be careful. This is plastic into metal tabs. You don't want to over tighten these. You just want to snug them. That's it. Nice and snug. Nice and solid. I don't know. I don't think I need to bring you guys into the back seat, but I'll show a quick clip from the beginning. Basically, you have the two bolts. Slide back here. You have the two bolts on either side of this. These are those are 10 millimeters. They're these. This guy here. All right, and then the plastic clip that goes to cover it. So I'm going to take care of that, and I will be right back. All right, so the center console is back in. As I mentioned earlier, the key fob detection issue has been solved. Once I plugged in this harness, everything came back to life. Do a little cleaning around the edges. Anybody else do this? Drop a comment below if you're OCD like I am and have to clean everything when you have it apart. Now, one thing you want to make sure of, all of these clips are firmly pressed in place. Now, the next thing is you want to make sure you've got that plug here, right there. This red guy right here, it's keyed so it only goes in one way. You're going to want to plug that in. Keyway goes up, by the way. Listen for that audible click. Now, there's two top pins here and here going first. You want to press them in firmly, and then the rest go down. That's it. Now we got the interior put back together again. Like I said, we're going to leave the shift boot area open. Let's get my pro clip installed again. Now mind you, I did a 15-minute video on how to install the pro clip. And there you go. I'll sum that up into 30 seconds. Now the pro clip is back into place. I have two shift knobs. I'm gonna install the Barton shift knob first for those of you who get the Barton kit. I went with the Barton with the orange accent. So we're gonna screw this lock nut down. And we are going to screw down the ball, get your shift pattern exactly the way you want it. I have a 10 millimeter open end here. And we're going to use that to just lock the shift ball in place. There we go. All right, so now we have the Barton shift ball in place. Now this is the stock Barton shift ball. We're gonna stick with that for now and make our adjustments. So what I'm thinking, this is third and second gear. I think that's good. I'm gonna tighten two of these bolts just to make sure it doesn't, move. There we go. Yeah, pretend that didn't happen. I really do know how to work a ratchet. It's just, I'm getting tired. It was a long night putting together another video for you guys. All right, so I got one on each side tightened. There's not a lot of shift throw here. It feels really nice. Okay, cool. One of the things I failed to mention and I'm noticing now, so I'm gonna bring you guys back down a shaky cam and show you this because I totally forgot about this. Come back down here. Okay, you see right here, there's a cable. See it moving right there? That's actually getting hit by the shifter. There is a little hole right down there that this cable fits into. So that cable, there's a hole in there that cable fits in and routes away from the shifter. So now there's no cable in the way of the shifter. All right. Cool. Everything's looking good. I think this is the way I like it. I'm gonna bring you guys back up topside. First, second, third, fourth. Sixth gear. Who uses sixth gear? So I'm gonna go and tighten this back down. Don't wanna go for a test drive with loose bolts here. I noticed that as you tighten one in, one piece down, the other ones get loose. So I would work in a cross pattern until you feel they're all tight. They're all snug. You flatten out those lock washers real good. Just a tip, that's all. Oh yeah, look at that. When you pull it back into gear, it's much easier to access those back ones. Just a word of advice there. Took me like a half hour to figure out there. What an idiot. All right, so I'm gonna take off the Barton ball. There you go, just break it free. And unscrew it. Now, I mean, no offense to the guys at Barton. I mean, they make a freaking quality product. It's just that I've had my eye on this Speed Dawg shift ball since I got my Challenger. And, this doesn't cut it for me. The Speed Dawg ball, it's a little bit bigger and a whole lot more badass. So when you order the Speed Dawg, you go look online and they actually have the specs for the Barton. So you're gonna want to install an insert into here. Let's go ahead and do that now. Now Speed Dawg gives you everything you need to install it on the Barton shifter or any other shifter that you have. I just couldn't put this on the stock Challenger shifter without the ball's not screwed on, so without yanking off the ball and, you know, doing any kind of major damage. All right, so I'm gonna go around right there, and that's exactly where I want it, right there. Lock it in place. Now that's what I'm talking about. And it's a very, very, very close match to the Barton. I'm gonna go ahead and bring this down. And this is the Speed Dawg Rally Series knob. And there is it with the Barton shifter, or the Barton logo in orange on the side. I mean, I don't know. I've been eyeballing this for a long time, and it is one beautiful shift knob through and through. Inlay, it's not going to rub off or anything like that. It's just a gorgeous shift knob. All right, and I just noticed that I should probably turn it a little more, because I want the rally stripes to line up with the Barton shifter. So I'm going to go ahead and put you guys right there for a second. And now you can see an underside of the lock washer. And just get it in place. Let me try and do it off to the side there. So I line up my thingies. There we go. That's about right. And we give it a good snugging. There we go. Looks good. All right. I've just upgraded my man's mission to a slightly more manly man's mission. And we'll go take it for a test drive in a bit. We're gonna give it a shot. Take off the e-brake. Reverse. It just feels so much more solid. Holy crap. Wow, this feels good. It's like solid. That feels so much better. You got the shifter hat?
Yeah.
Does it fit on your head? All right. Let's loosen up the ball. There we go. We have to take the ball off.
Why?
Because we have to put the boot back on. And I have the boot, you know, I had to adjust the shifter to make sure it was perfect. Okay, so I hope in the newer Challengers, this has got a rubber band around it, so I'm hoping I could pull it around this really fat Barton area here. I guess we'll find out. Bring this all the way down. Oh, it helps to get it in the right position. All right. Does it make it all the way down? That's a really tight fit there, bud. Am I gonna be able to do that? There's an O-ring on here, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut the O-ring because it's way too tight to get around, and I don't like how it sits all the way down here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut the O-ring, which you can see right there. And then break it. Then we're gonna pull that O-ring out. Hey, bud, do you remember that bag that was in the glove box?
Oh, yeah.
Can you get that bag for me, buddy? Okay.
The only bag I could find it.
Just give it a good slam. Good job. We're gonna use the zip tie that Barton included. I'm going to thread it through the holes that the O-ring went through. Now, I don't know if this is going to fit or not, so I'm just going to thread it through just in case. Is that a good idea?
Yeah.
So in case we get it right the first time, we don't have to take it out again.
Wait, you're cutting it?
No, I cut it already. Can't get my finger in there now. All right, gotta do a little bit more.
Yay!
Oh, that says that it goes on when the car is on. That's what the key means. That means when the car's turned on, that turned on.
Why does it open and go up?
Because that's where you plug stuff in. Oh. All right, I got it. Okay, so...
You're awesome.
I know, isn't that awesome? You're awesome, man.
Yeah.
Okay, so to get this done, what we did was we cut the O-ring and we pried it around. I got it 3/4 of the way around. And then I just used a little bit of leverage from an interior tool to get it the rest of the way. Then we're going to use the Barton zip tie that was included. Pull this nice and tight. Get it in that groove. That turns the vents on and off. You don't get to sit up in the front a lot, do you? Okay, we snip off the end of the zip tie and we slide it down. What do you think? You think it's gonna work?
Yeah.
That's the hard part, getting that to go down blue. Got it. It's in. What do you think?
Looks good.
Okay, we just pop in the clips. You wanna push in the clips? Push down. Really hard. Put all your muscles in it. Good job. Another one? Good. Do that one. Do this one. Okay. And then I'll go around one more time. Everything looks good. Should we put the ball back on?
Yep.
All right. So here, why don't you put this, you got to screw this down. Good. That one.
4, 5, 6.
And what is that?
R.
What is that doing there?
That doesn't belong in numbers.
You know what R is for?
What
does reverse start with?
R.
There you go.
Rainbow.
Rainbow? Wouldn't it be cool if this car farts rainbows?
Wow, 48 minutes. If you stuck around this long, I should be able to hit your like button. Hopefully this video encourages some of you to install your own shifter upgrades. So far, I like the Barton. But I'm going to reserve my review until our trip to the Strip next month. If you enjoyed this video, please gently press that like button. If you're stopping by for the first time, don't forget to subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching.